Martijn, you talked about your crowdfunding experiences. What did you think the crowd in front of you found the most interesting? And then speaking of like the low points in crowdfunding.
I hope was the most interesting that I, and that's also what I started with my presentation. I said, okay, at the end of my story, you're going to have more questions than from the start, but you will have better questions. So I think what the crowd liked was that they really were taken into the world of crowdfunding from the practical side. I shared my learnings and especially also my mistakes, and that was for a great help for the crowd, I hope.
And talking about better questions, what were questions they had before and questions they had after? What kind of questions do I have to think about?
First, I shared my story about my equity-based crowdfunding campaign I did in 2011. And the mistakes that I made over there was the first one, I didn't thought about, okay, why are people going to invest? Are they giving me money because of the shares or because they want the book? Looking back, they wanted the book and not the shares. So that was a really important lesson. Also about the validation of the crowd company, where I validated my book on 100,000 euro because I sold 20% of the book for 20,000 euro. Looking back, but also by then, everybody could know this is a absolute crazy validation. But also really important: do the investors know what they are buying and how do we protect these investors?
So that's a question you left them with.
Yes, question and homework, because I really think that people are really have to start thinking about that, because when you look at, okay, how can we make crowdfunding a long-term a sustainable model, then these questions have to be answered.
What are the most important things you learned from your first campaign that you could use in your second?
The decision about which platform I was going to use. Besides that, also decision if I was going to use a platform, because you can also crowdfund without using a platform, but using a platform has some really additional benefits. The crowd, how I can use the crowd to share the story. So with my second campaign, everybody who donated 10 euro received a Vine video, a small video, a small thank you video. And those people, because you're going to facilitate them with personal contents, they're going to share it with their network. So we had a really big exposure by making these small videos. And I really used crowdfunding for storytelling in the second campaign, not really because of the money.
Is this also something you're going to do with your third campaign? Because there's a third campaign coming up on Indiegogo.
Yeah, that's a pure way I was experimenting how can we use crowdfunding to get things done. So we wanted, I wanted to have an interview with one of the founders of Indiegogo. And normally then you call the press department and then they say, okay, Martijn, CNN, then I lose. And so I was thinking, okay, how can I get in contact with the founders? Because if they say yes, then it will be arranged. So I made a video and a social media campaign where I said to the founders, okay, I want to make a deal. If you say yes to my interview requests, then I will crowdfund the money I need to get to you by using your platform. And they thought that was really amazing and really great. So in 4 hours later, the founder sent me a tweet, Martijn, awesome approach, let's do it. So then the main goal of the crowdfunding campaign is getting the interview.
And when is the next campaign going to start?
In 2 weeks, at the end of October.
And how much money do you need this time?
At least 3,000 euro, because Sebastian and I are going to San Francisco to do the interviews. But we're also going to introduce some stretch goals, because we really want to make more journeys, have more interviews. We also have interviews at Wikipedia in San Francisco and other really great crowd initiatives. So the basic goal is 3,000, and from there we go up with stretch goals.
Have you learned some lessons in your second campaign that you're going to use this time?
Yes, second campaign was a really hard campaign, because I was crowdfunding for the crowd expedition, and there were two really different hard things about this campaign. One, it wasn't really a concrete question, because crowd expedition is a project of 2 years, so it's not okay, give me money for this gadget or for this event, but give me money for this project we're going to do. So it was really a hard proposition to sell. And the second one was that now I've got a second one.
But this is also a project. This is not something you can buy, going to San Francisco and interviewing. So what's the difference?
It's really concrete. You're going to give money for the tickets, and then we go to San Francisco. Then you can follow the expedition by using WhatsApp. You can have a keynote of me or Sebastian in San Francisco. So it's a really concrete project of 1.5 weeks. So we are getting the stories out of the crowd initiatives and give them back to the crowd. So they're really helping us to share the stories of this crowd initiatives and also the lessons and give it back to the crowd.
Thank you and good luck.
Thank you.